Amigos de Propulsión, ya estamos en el Aeroshow Cozumel 2012. Nos encontramos nada más y nada menos que con Jack Knudson. Jack, how are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
We have just seen your plane in action. What about Cozumel? Is this a right place for your routine?
Yeah, it's a beautiful site here for it. Really no complaints at all. I mean, the weather's beautiful. It's kind of humid and stuff, which takes away a little bit of performance, but it's well worth it.
Perfect. What about your plane? Just tell me the model and why red?
Why red? Well, red's easiest to see from the ground, so I figured I'd have the brightest airplane up there. It's an extra 300. It's a German-built airplane. It's mostly carbon fiber. A little bit of wood. There's wood ribs in the wings, and a little bit of wood back in the tail that holds the fabric where it is, and a little bit of steel in the tail holding everything together. But mostly carbon fiber to keep it light and strong.
Y bueno, seguimos analizando el avión de nuestro buen Jack Knudson. Ahora nos va a explicar un poquito sobre las palas, que son de paso variable, y también sobre unas cositas del motor.
Okay, well, the propeller, if you look real close, or if you listen real close, it's hollow. That's to make it as light as possible. It's hollow carbon fiber with a metal leading edge to protect it when we fly through the rain. And we were talking about the intake, where the air breathes, or actually the propeller itself. It changes pitch also as you fly. When you go really fast, it takes a big bite out of the air so it doesn't overspeed the engine. If you fly real slow, it takes a real small bite out of it, almost like gears on a car. You know, you're flying slow, it'd be in first gear, and you really get it ripping, and it'll change the pitch, give you max performance, you know, on both sides without hurting the engine. And it does it all automatically. You don't even have to touch it. You just set it for takeoff, and it'll keep that same RPM the whole flight, hopefully.
Ese es un punto muy importante. En la Segunda Guerra Mundial, los pilotos de los Spitfire precisamente tenían ese problema. Lo que hace las palas de paso variable es que van cambiando para dar mayor potencia o mayor velocidad dependiendo de la posición en la que se encuentren, que es lo que nos está explicando nuestro buen amigo Jack Knudson.
Oh, Keep watching Propulsion TV. Don't change that channel.
Well, the cockpit is real basic. We just put the minimum instruments in. We don't put any extra weight in it. And we don't have any gyros in it either. Gyros are what normally tell you what the attitude of the airplane is. We can't have those because when we're doing this, it'll mess them all up. It'll break them. They cost too much money, so we just leave them out. The only problem is when we bring this airplane to the shows or we fly it from point A to point B, we don't have what all the other airplanes have. So when you're flying in the clouds, it's real easy to get disorientated and get in trouble. So we either got to be below the clouds or above them, but we can't go through them. So, but just real basic engine instruments. All we care about is we got oil pressure and oil temperature. We use the airspeed a fair amount and the altimeter a fair amount. The other thing we always do is we set our altimeter to zero every time, so we know exactly where the ground is.
Amigos de Propulsión, seguimos en el Aero Show 2012 y adivinen con quién estamos. Estamos con Skip Stewart. Skip, how are you?
I'm doing well. I'm happy to be here in Cozumel.
What about your plane? Could you tell us about your plane, the characteristics of it?
Yeah, this is a very special airplane. It started off as a 1979 Pitts S2S, a factory airplane. I took that airplane completely apart all the way down to the bare frame, and then I used that frame to build a custom airplane out of. So it's a very special. It's twice as strong as it was originally. It has almost twice the horsepower and twice the control surfaces, so the maneuver's better. It's a very special plane.
Perfect. What about the materials of the plane?
The actual materials started with in about the 1940s, so the materials are the same for the most part as they were then. The wings are made of wood, spruce and Douglas fir, covered with a fabric that's polyester fabric. There's been many upgrades. The fuselage is chrome moly steel tubing, truss work. And there's some aluminum, there's some carbon fiber. Most of the improvements have been made in those kind of materials, carbon fiber and titanium and things like that.
Why a biplane? It's very interesting because we see all the planes, but yours it's very characteristic. Why a biplane?
I think a biplane is much more exciting to watch. I think it's more exciting to fly. If you're looking for pure performance, you know, speed and roll rate and those things, monoplanes are better. But if you're looking to entertain a crowd, look like you're out of control, I think biplanes are much more fun to watch and much more fun to fly.
Pues ahí lo tienen, amigos. Si se trata de show, el correcto es Skip Stewart con su biplano. Continuamos con más de Propulsión.
Thank you. Hey, this is Mike Miranda for Propulsion TV Mexico. So, Patty, wow, your performance was awesome. We were down there screaming and all loud. Thank you.
Cool, flying here in Cozumel.
How's been this air show in Cozumel?
You know, it was really good. I thought it was well organized. The performers all had a good time, but it's hard to concentrate because as soon as you take off, you see this blue water and it's so beautiful. And you know, you have to go, okay, I gotta concentrate.
You have like not so many references. I mean, like ponds where you can make a path, or maybe the sky. They say, well, this isn't.
We're always looking at the runway. You know, every airport's different, so you always have the runway. You always know where the runway is, and you're always aiming for the runway, and that's what you cue off.
Okay. Yeah. So tell us about the time when you said, I like that. I want to fly like that.
That's exactly what happened. I went to an air show in Canada and said, that's what I want to do.
Wow.
Yeah.
How long have been?
25 years.
25 years?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm late. I can do that right now.
Yeah.
So after this, you're going to some other place? Or?
I go home. I've been gone for 2 weeks and I go home, and then I have a show in 2 weeks. So.
Okay, and you're from?
Florida. Northern Florida. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah, it's close. I yeah. Have to fly over there.
Yeah, I have somebody who's going to fly my plane over there for me. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.